So I'm sitting in a doctor's office right now, waiting on some test results.
Is this me in the doctor's office?
Getting that health care that I so rightly deserve as an American citizen.
And let me just say, I found out at the doctor's office that I could be potentially seriously sick. So I got an attitude about that. Then I got an attitude because my documentation got messed up. To handle some business, messing up my money. It's the first of the month. Ain't nobody in the mood for this type of stuff. Like, nobody want to go through this. This is the time of the month where you handle the most business. Oh, now he done locked himself out of the damn car. Today, I'm irritated. Like, I'm seriously irritated today, and nobody understands that. Oh, we gotta stop. I gotta get some lashes. He spent most of the day at the doctor's office just to find out some shit that I already knew.
There's some shit you need to get done. Prolong.
Who's prolonging anything? What are you talking about?
You avoiding it like it's gonna go away.
Booty don't seem to understand how much I do around the house until I'm not there. So God forbid I have to stay in the hospital because I'm getting surgery. God forbid I have to stay in the hospital for longer than a weekend. He would be assed out.
That's wild.
If I had to stay in the hospital for longer than 2 days, he wouldn't know how to manufacture his life.
That's a
wild. He wouldn't know how to take care of his kids.
Liar.
He wouldn't know how to provide. Booty literally needs me to be there with him. That's why I do what I do, to make sure I'm there for him, to think I am his other half. You ever heard somebody say that, you know, my wife is my rib? I'm more than just a rib for him. I'm half of his brain.
You feeling yourself?
Half of his brain.
You feeling yourself?
He needs me.
She didn't give you no medication?
He needs me. She didn't give me no medication. I know you need me. You don't think you need me? That's what you're doing. You ate your banana?
Yeah.
You finished? You feel better?
What you doing?
What happened?
You changed my mind the last second, like somebody waiting on them or something.
I'm nauseous now.
The medicine she gave you making you nauseous?
She ain't give me no medicine, Booney. You gonna sit here and say that I'm sick because I said you need me? Did you say I'm your everything? Did you say I'm your everything? Yes or no? Yes or no? Did you say that I'm your everything? Yes or no? Did you say I'm your everything? Oh, you don't want to say that now?
Yes, that's what I said. I don't understand what the point is.
The point is, how the hell do you go a day or two without everything?
What I'm saying to you, I would do that if I have to. You got to get straight.
I don't like to be away from my family.
It's about what you like. You got to make some sacrifices so you can be there for a longer time.
I'm not cranky and in pain. I'm just upset. And I don't put my problems on people, so don't do that. I'm sitting here saying if I'm in pain or I'm upset, I make your life miserable.
That's not what I'm saying. Why be in pain if you don't have to be?
You going to get my lashes, right?
You going to the store first.
I told you I need some.
You said you need some juice too. You got everything.
Fine. We are at the doctor's office for Avery. Avery, say hi.
Hi. Say hi.
Say hi, Dad.
Hi.
Okay, so Avery has a lump on his breast. He like me saying breasts. So you got a lump on your breast?
Yes.
Avery got a lump on his breast.
People call it nipples.
Avery has a lump on his nipples, and I'm sorry. What you want to say? He got a lump on his nipples, and he says it hurts. So we're at the doctor's office trying to figure out what's going on. Can you shut up? We are in the doctor's office.
This is a doctor's office. Why you keep saying put my shirt on? I'm in a doctor's office. I'm supposed to be wearing this gown.
No,
I'm not. Yes, I am.
You're supposed to look fabulous.
I'm supposed to what? I'm supposed to look fabulous?
Yeah.
I do look.
Hello.
Anyway. Alright. So. We about to get checked out. That's the doctor that's going to be looking at me. Dr. Jones. Okay, so we are at the gynecologist. I'm about to get checked out. Look at that. She got on her gynecologist outfit on.
What did he got? He did it on.
He said, put your shirt on.
Hello. My name is Dad. I have a cute eye. Remember?
He said, my name is Dash, and I know I'm cute.
How is that?
Dash, you farted?
No.
Yes, you did.
No, you farted.
Sit back. You farted. Nasty stuff. Dash farted, and this is so gross. You are so loud. Stop. Be quiet. Why are you so loud? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm looking for something because I know that he farted. So, of course, they're going to look at me like, ooh, she stink. Make no sense.
Yeah.
I don't like that.
Oh, yeah, I got.
Making me look like I stink.
No, I think you ain't looking at it.
You nasty.
No, you nasty.
No, I'm not. Don't do that.
Oh.
So gross. Okay, sorry about that. Dash farted and I had to spray something because he was making it look like I was the one that was stinking in the doctor's office. Don't nobody need that.
What?
Dash! I'm gonna give you some gummy bears when we get in the house.
Yay!
Candy? Yes, you'll get some gummy bear candy.
Yay!
You excited?
Yeah!
I love you.
Yeah.
I love you more.
I love you more.
You're my best friend.
You're my best friend.
Okay, so just left the gynecologist office. Doctor checking on my private parts. Dash was with me. Dash is in the backseat. Dash, say hi.
Hi.
So anyway, Dash is sitting there on the side of the table while the lady is checking my private parts, giving me my pap smear and all that, my examination. And this boy is sitting on the side of the table saying, mommy, it's gonna be okay. Mommy, I hope it doesn't hurt. You wanna hold my hand? Then he takes my hand and he's stroking my hand like this while she's giving me a pap smear. Talk about, it doesn't hurt, mommy. It's gonna be fine. It's gonna be okay. You're a big girl. You're not gonna cry. He's 2 years old. He will be 3 at the end of this month. But this boy, 2 years old, is trying to console me, show me some compassion while I'm in the middle of getting my coochie checked. That's the kind of things that I have to go through when I'm at the gynecologist with my sons. I need a daughter. Like, what in the world? I'm in the gynecologist with my sons. I remember when I was pregnant with Dash and Avery was in there with me saying the same stuff like, mommy, it's gonna be okay, it's not gonna hurt, stroking my hand and all this. I mean, I don't need all of that. I need you to act like you're not even here. What I need you to do is to sit in the corner and pretend that you're not even here. That's my children. I love them to death, but sometimes you gotta take them to the gynecologist with you.